Today in this video we are telling you a very interesting story about Princess of Bhopal, Abida Sultana, a great grandmother of Safina's son Taimur, who was the first Muslim woman pilot to fly a plane. Abida Sultan was the second woman pilot in India and the first Muslim woman to get a license to fly a plane. She learned to fly a plane from Bombay Flying Club and Kolkata Flying Club along with the plane. She was also very fond of driving and running the car. All Bollywood on one side and the charm of Safina's son Taimur Baba on one side. Apart from these, if Taimur will look at the family history at some points in his age, then he will understand the status of the family of Nawab, as well as he will also know that he belongs to such a royal family whose coin is not only his compatriots gathering in. Today, suddenly, on the pretext of Safina's son, I tried to peep into her history because a link of the Patodi family, which originates from the princely state of Bhopal, goes to Pakistan. The name of this episode is Abida Sultan. Abida Sultan, the eldest daughter of Hamidullah, the last Nawab of the princely state of Bhopal. But her introduction is not just like being the daughter of Nawab. Her introduction is that she used to fly planes in those times when it was impossible for women to leave the house. Hunting was his pastime, and her skill was to solve political issues. Abida's talk is because she had passed away on today's date, 11th May 2002. To understand the relationship with Saif Karina, they go to Pakistan. Shahyar Khan has been a well-known diplomat in Pakistan. He has been in the foreign service in Pakistan, has been ambassador to many countries. Apart from this, he has also been the chairman of the Pakistan Cricket Board. Today, at the age of 87, Shahyar enjoys great respect in Pakistan. The reason for this is their own existence as well as the fame earned by their ancestors. His mother Abida Sultan has a big role in this. Actually, Shahyar Khan was born in the Nawabi family of Bhopal in 1934. Shahyar's mother Abida and cricketer Nawab Mansur Ali Khan's Patodi's mother Sajida Begum were real sisters. Due to this relationship, Shahyar seems to be Sharmila Tagore's brother-in-law, Saif Ali Khan's uncle, and Kareena's uncle, father-in-law. In the year 1926, Hamidullah became the last Nawab of the princely state of Bhopal. They did not have any sons, but have three daughters: the elder daughter Abida Sultan, the middle Sajida Sultan, and the younger Rabia Sultan. Hamidullah made Sajida the middle daughter of the princely estate after him, although she had to give this responsibility to Abida. But Abida got married and settled in Pakistan. She refused to come to India. After this, the younger daughter Rabia also went to her in-law's house. Sajida Begum was married to Iftihar Ali Khan, the Nawab of the Patodi royal family. Both of them had three children. the eldest of which was Mansoor Ali Khan Pathodi. He became a cricketer and married Sharmila Tagore. Later, Nawabiyat also happened to him. Abida was also ahead in politics according to the condition of India at that time. If not directly in the freedom movement, her ideological contribution was also her. She also went to round table conference, which she has mentioned in one of her books. Abida Sultan was married on 18 June 1926 to Sarwar Ali Khan, the Nawab of Kurwai, in 1949. She left India and went to Pakistan. Abida Sultan made her home in Karachi. The marriage with her husband did not last long. Abida took the custody of son Shahyar. Abida Sultan was a rebellious princess from the beginning. She was a courageous woman. She used to do all those things which other women could not even imagine at that time. She was fond of hunting since childhood. She has hunted 73 lions in her entire life, most of which is before the age of 20 years. Abida Sultan was the second woman pilot in India and the first Muslim woman to get a license to fly a plane. She learned to fly a plane from Bombay Flying Club and Kolkata Flying Club. Along with the plane, she was also very fond of driving and running the car. As a child, her grandmother inspired her to learn cars. A black Daimler car used to park in the morning, in which Abida herself used to drive the car to take her grandmother to her favorite place. Abida Sultan's autobiography exists under the name Memoir of a Princess. It is mentioned in this that she had to face many difficulties in Pakistan, but gradually the conditions became favorable. She became the first woman protocol minister of Pakistan in 1954. She was sent by Pakistan as an ambassador to the United Nations, and in 1958 she was Pakistan's ambassador to Chile and Brazil. Princess Abida Sultan died of a heart attack on 11th May 2002 in hospital in Karachi.